Recently, there has been a lot of debate about controversial place names, one of the big ones being Kitchener, Ontario. So where did the name Kitchener come from? Kitchener was once named Berlin, Ontario, due to a large German population, but it was renamed in 1916. The city of Kitchener is named after Herbert Horatio Kitchener, a British military officer born in 1850. He served as chief of staff for the British Army during the Second Boer War. During the First World War, Kitchener was the British Secretary of State, where he was immensely popular and celebrated for his military victories. At the same time, anti-German sentiment was growing in Canada, and there was a push to rename Berlin. Kitchener was killed by a German submarine on June 5, 1916. His vote was added last minute to the voting ballot, where it won by a narrow margin of only 346 votes, compared to the second place, Brock, with 335 votes. Voter turnout was low, and almost 20% of these voters spoiled their ballots. On September 1, 1916, Berlin had officially become Kitchener. It was not a very popular decision. It was a name chosen out of spite for the German population and a desire to glorify Britain. But this is only a very small part of the controversy surrounding the name today. There have been multiple calls to reject the Kitchener name, and support is growing. Some have suggested going back to the name Berlin to reconnect with the area's German heritage, which still persists today. So why the name Kitchener, and why is it so controversial? If it was so complicated to change the name in the first place, why are people considering changing it again?
So who was Lord Kitchener? Lord Herbert Horatio Kitchener lived from 1850 to 1916. He was a British Army officer and imperial administrator who is mainly known for his involvement in the Boer War and the First World War. His successful military involvements earned him the title of First Earl of Kitchener. Many of the British people perceived him as a hero for his dedication to the expansion of the British Empire. His reputation eventually caused him to become a symbol of national will to victory. Kitchener began his work in the military when he worked as a surveyor for the British Army in Western Palestine. Here he rose to the ranks and became governor of the British Red Sea territories. In 1883, Kitchener was dispatched to serve in the British Army in Egypt, where he was promoted to captain and helped reconstruct the Egyptian army. In 1892, his eagerness and thorough work ethic caused him to be appointed head of the Egyptian army. During a time of conflict over which European powers would control the Middle East, Kitchener was very influential in British operations. Britain wanted to be able to link all of the African countries it controlled, from Egypt in the north to South Africa. The missing link in this endeavor was Sudan. In 1885, the British were forced out of Sudan, and Kitchener was appointed the head of the army to reconquer it in 1896. In 1898, Kitchener led the British forces to victory during the Battle of Omdurman, with their opponents, the Mahdists, suffering a 90% casualty rate. Kitchener became a national hero across Britain as the man who conquered the missing link. In 1900, 1 year into the Second Boer War, Kitchener was appointed overall war commander. His ruthless strategies forced the Boers to submit to British rule, and any questions about Kitchener's methods were overshadowed by the excitement of victory.
Over the next decade, Kitchener continued working in important positions such as commander-in-chief in India and returned to Egypt to be British agent and consul general. When World War I broke out in 1914, Kitchener was made Secretary of State for the war. Unlike others, he predicted a long war which would involve many different countries. Because of this, he encouraged many to sign up and soon became a symbol of national will to victory. He was put on the famous Lord Kitchener Wants You posters to encourage his large recruitment campaign. He also built the British Expeditionary Force, or the BEF. Lord Kitchener died in 1916 when a ship he was on was hit by a mine planted by a German U-boat. So why is Lord Kitchener considered controversial? How could a man who was once deemed a hero across the British Empire become a topic of controversy today? Lord Kitchener is mainly considered controversial for his actions during the Boer War. He orchestrated the burning of many homes in the Boer region. Once they had burned their homes, then they confined the women and children to concentration camps.
In these concentration camps, around 26,000 women and children died as a result of disease and malnutrition. A War Office inquiry was held on the camps, and they found that the camps fell to this state due to an administrative incompetence and neglect. Many consider Kitchener responsible for this crime. His victory at the Battle of Omdurman is also considered controversial due to the fact that Kitchener permitted the death of many already wounded soldiers, which was criticized as unnecessarily cruel. One officer wrote about Kitchener in September of 1896, saying, "He was always inclined to bully his own entourage, as some men are rude to their wives. He was inclined to let off his spleen on those around him. He was often morose and silent for hours together. He was even morbidly afraid of showing any feeling or enthusiasm, and he preferred to be misunderstood rather than be suspected of human feeling." Lord Kitchener is known today as the man who invented concentration camps. Although this wasn't the first time concentration camps were used, this inhumane war strategy potentially influenced and intensified the use of concentration camps, particularly by Hitler in World War II and others as well. Such methods of extreme cruelty used to win a war should not be celebrated, but was Kitchener fully to blame? Should a city named after such a man consider changing its name because of his controversial actions? In recent years, the Kitchener name change debate is getting stronger responses from its citizens. People are asking for a vote on whether or not Kitchener should change its name. At the same time, educational institutions are teaching people the history of Berlin and Kitchener. The following is a news report of people's opinions on changing Kitchener's name.
Changing a name is not going to change much. It may change some symbols, but we have much more urgent business to do.
The Kitchener name involves issues of racism, historical and cultural values, and more arguments happening in this city. Therefore, many citizens of Kitchener support renaming the city. But a lot of people who support the name change do not know the history, nor do they know where the controversy of the name change came from or why it should be changed. It is just called herd mentality. Only by fully understanding the history can we make an accurate judgment and understand that the names of Kitchener and Berlin are equally significant to its history. A large group of people do not agree with the name change. In the public Facebook post, it is argued that, "More than a century after it was chosen, our name is not a celebration of an individual leader's hurtful legacy. Today it is a celebration of the many hundreds of thousands of people who came after him and who have worked tirelessly together to give our city such an important and positive legacy." A different post argues that, "There is no room in our city for hate, and this name sure does have some heavy meaning behind it. We should be detaching ourselves from the atrocities committed through history, but instead we are glorifying those responsible." According to a statement from the city of Kitchener, there are no plans at this time to change the city's name. There are many reasons for this. Changing the city's name would come with a huge financial cost. One marketing expert said it could easily tally $1 million.
You physically have to change every building, truck, municipal garbage can, vehicle, letterheads, everything.
In 2020, the fiscal revenue of all provinces and municipalities has declined in Canada. Due to the 2020 COVID-19 pandemic and related measures taken to contain the virus, it has changed all aspects of life. The impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic are obvious. Reduced employment opportunities, declining economic income levels. Since March, the tourism industry has been forced to shut down, and many vacate enterprises have gone bankrupt one after another. And this pandemic trend is about to spread to next year, where no one knows when to usher in a turnaround.
Now, these calls from political leaders asking people not to travel to other cities also comes with a plea
latest on
for
troubles
us
at Waterloo Region's COVID-19 testing sites, traffic issues, and threats against staff. Forced the drive-thru assessment center in Kitchener to close early today.
And the center was shut down.
The government ordered a lockdown of all the cities around Kitchener during the COVID-19 pandemic. Citizens are suffering from traffic issues and violent violations of law and discipline. Meanwhile, people also face the challenge of psychological problems. It is not appropriate to accept more changes.
The Canadian Mental Health Association says the pandemic is having an impact on people's mental well-being. According to a nationwide survey, nearly 40% of people say their mental health has declined due to COVID-19.
Only a third of those surveyed say they're doing fine both mentally and financially. Almost a quarter of Canadians say their finances are fine, but their mental health has taken a blow. And more than a quarter of Canadians say both their mental health and finances have worsened since COVID-19 hit.
Changing the name of the city at this time will shake people's hearts and make them feel like the city they knew is gone, increasing people's psychological burden and the tense atmosphere of the pandemic. It will increase hidden dangers for Social Security. The renaming issue, originally intended to alleviate racism and social issues, will aggravate the poorest in the region due to the enormous expense, which is harmful and useless. Changing the name at this point does not adjust any pressing issues at the moment. In conclusion, Kitchener should not be renamed as a way to solve the problems left over by history. However, there are two ways we can address this controversy. First, the government can choose one day of the year to become a city holiday. Create another cultural anniversary to let people celebrate and remember the history of Kitchener and Berlin. Secondly, we can encourage public historians to set up online museums and cultural museums and apps. Let people learn and see history freely on the internet. In this way, more people will be able to understand the city and the reasons behind its name. More and more people will fall in love with the city and bring resources and vitality to the city. This will promote consensus, respect, and harmonious coexistence among people of different cultures, races, and languages in Canada.